Hi everyone, welcome back to this channel, Chess Master and Class. So this topic is about chess tactics. It is called deflection. So how to deflect your opponent's defensive piece. So in this position, you cannot make a double attack, check, because the bishop will capture the knight on e6. But in chess tactics, or using tactical ideas, you can deflect the bishop, or to remove the bishop from this diagonal line. So the natural ideas is to play bishop e6, and if bishop takes bishop is not correct, because after knight takes bishop, so there is a double attack and black lose his queen. So the other natural move is to play knight e6, double attack, but black can capture the knight on e6, and after bishop takes e6, and the position is still equal, or white has no winning material. So the correct ideas to deflect the bishop is to capture the pawn on b7. So bishop takes b7 is a strong move, not only threatening to create double attack, but also threatening to capture the rook, and black will lose material. So for example, black move his queen to e6 at d7, then bishop takes rook. So if bishop takes b7, then there is a winning move, double attack. Knight e7, after king move, the queen is captured. So next position. So in this position, black to move. So the natural ideas, or if you want to trade your pieces, so bishop takes knight, and white can play queen takes knight, or pawn takes knight. So it depends on his decision. But in this position, rook e3 is the strongest move. So this is the idea, to deflect the queen on this square, because if queen d1, then there is bishop takes knight and pawn takes knight, pawn takes bishop, then queen takes e3, then black is better in this position. But after rook e3, if b takes e3, then black play bishop takes c3, and followed by bishop takes rook, and black is winning. Okay, next example. So what is the ideas of white in this position? So he wants to deflect the rook on d7, because he cannot check the king on d6 because of this rook. If he can make this move, then the king is checked, and he can continue to attack the king. So if the rook back to d7, then capture the rook, and there is a skewer of capturing the queen on h8 next move. So this is how to work out your tactics in chess. So what you learn about chess tactics? chess tactics is a move or a very strong move that wins material, or you can checkmate the king. So that is the move that you want to find on the chessboard. So in this position, white play rook is 7, and if rook is 7, then there is queen d6 capturing the rook next move. So if black moves his king to 8, then there is queen takes e7. And if black moves his king to c8, then there is rook c1 followed by c8. So for example, instead of rook takes a7, black play rook bb7 to defend his rook on d7. And now in this position, so there is a strong move, queen e8, and skewering the queen. So this is a skewer move and capture the queen. So the idea is to capture the rook on d7. Rook takes d7, then queen e8, after king c7, then capture the queen, and white is winning. But after rook takes e7, queen d6 check, and this is a good combination for white. After rook c1, king b7, and queen c6, and white is winning. So that is the result of chess tactics. Okay, next example. So in this position, how to deflect the rooks on f7 and g8? So meaning, if you can deflect the two rooks because this rook defends the f8 square, then you can capture the queen next move, because that is the target of your ideas, is to play rook f8. So this is the ideas. Knight takes g7, knight f takes g7. So this is the ideas. Another ideas that brings white a good winning chances is to play knight e or knight f takes g7, and then if rook takes g7, because there is a check followed by check if black will not capture the knight. So if rook takes g7, then rook takes g7, rook takes g7, and knight g8. So the same ideas. So here is another example. Instead of knight f takes g7, so the same ideas might it happen after knight f takes g7, then rook g takes g7 followed by rook takes g7 check, and rook takes g7, because if black move his king, then there is queen takes e6 mate. So that's why black is forced to capture the rook after rook g7, rook takes g7, and knight f8, not knight takes g7, because you lose a piece. So knight takes f8 is winning. And after king move, then the queen is captured. So the other move is knight f takes g7. So the same ideas, rook takes g7, or rook f takes g7, rook takes g7, rook takes g7, and knight f8. And white is winning a piece. So next position. So how to deflect the pawn on or the bishop on e3? So this is black to move. The bishop on e3 defend or guard the square on f4, so that black knight cannot move to f4 or create a double attack, because of after knight f4, bishop takes f4. So how to deflect the bishop is to capture the knight on c5 and threatening to capture the bishop with queen takes d6. So after queen takes c5, there's a lot of possible good moves for white. He can play rook fd1 to protect the knight on d6, or knight f5. This is a counter move to protect to move away the knight on d6. So if white play bishop takes queen, then there is knight f4 check. So after king move and capture the queen, and followed by bishop takes d6. So the correct ideas after queen takes c5 is to play queen takes g6. So after queen takes d6, queen takes d6, bishop takes d6. The result of the endgame position is favorable for black because of 4 versus 3 pawn majority on the king side. So next example. So in this position, how to deflect the bishop? The bishop on c8 is defending the pawn on e6. So if you capture the bishop, then with your knight, then there is queen takes c8. So how to deflect the bishop? So this is the ideas of white, is to capture the pawn on b7. So this is the ideas how to deflect the bishop. So tactics is a very strong move. So this is a double attack. So if bishop takes if bishop takes knight, then there is knight takes e6 and winning the queen next move. But if queen e7, then there is knight takes d8 and winning by exchange. So another example. So how to deflect the bishop? So what is the other ideas of this position? So if you want to play rook takes c8, so this is a possible move because you can capture the pawn and threatening to mate next move. So if rook c7, then there is, so the correct move is queen. Take queen c7 and then queen takes pawn, followed by queen takes pawn. So that is a good trade. One bishop plus two pawns is equals rook. So the correct move is knight takes e6 to deflect the bishop. After bishop takes knight, then there is queen takes b7. So here is the move. Knight takes e6, followed by bishop takes e6 and queen takes b7. So there is mate on e7 after rook c8. So if he cannot castle kingside because of this bishop. So another ideas for white is to capture the bishop, followed by queen takes b7. So queen d8 to protect the e7 square, then queen takes pawn. That is another ideas for white. Okay, we go to the next example. So that is our topic about deflection. So another element of chess tactics. So always remember there are so many ideas or tactical element in chess. So in this position, how to deflect the rook, because the rook protect the bishop, so you cannot capture the bishop. So here is the ideas: rook b2. After rook b2, then there is rook takes bishop, check, followed by rook takes bishop. So that is how to deflect the pieces.